Now at 5, a 4-year-old boy is dead after contracting a rare brain-eating amoeba infection.
Health officials believe the boy might have come in contact with the amoeba while playing on a plastic toy water slide at a St. Bernard home.
Preliminary test results show the parish water system is not contaminated and the water is safe to drink. WDSU anchor Rachel Wolf just returned from St. Bernard Parish. She's here in the studio live with tonight's big local story.
Out of what officials are describing as an abundance of caution, St. Bernard Parish on Thursday began treating its water system with additional chlorine and flushing water from its lines.
Local, state, and federal authorities are monitoring the water supply in St. Bernard Parish after a 4-year-old boy died after contracting a brain-eating amoeba while playing on a slip and slide at a Violet home 5 weeks ago.
So the amoebas, if you push them way up your nose, they are going to crawl up into your brain, and that's when they create an encephalitis.
DHH officials say the parasitic amoeba has been around for years and is found in the soil and surface water.
Once in a while, these amoeba are going to make their way either in a water supply or in a broken pipe or something like that. They may even end up in the water in one house.
That appears to be what happened at that Violet home. The CDC confirms the amoeba was found in a garden hose, in a toilet tank, and the kitchen sink.
Does that concern you?
Well, it only concerns me in the fact that it's in the person's house. Now, we've checked the area, and we've done exhaustive testing of our water lines, of the parish water lines, and we're not finding it in the water lines.
The parish says it's flushing the water system and that it has found levels of chlorine high enough to kill any of the parasitic amoeba, but that the CDC is actually testing for it with results expected back in a few weeks. This isn't the first time someone has died from the parasitic amoeba. In 2011, a St. Bernard Parish man died after reportedly cleansing his sinuses with a neti pot using tap water. In that case, the home's water also tested positive for that parasitic amoeba. For now, health officials are advising people not to swim in fresh water.
If you are in a swimming pool, it has to be well chlorinated. If you are in a kiddie pool, and you are not too sure about the chlorination there, there are recommendations for the chlorine, or you watch the children so that they don't put their head underwater.
So again, the kiddie pools are really a big concern. Now, this is the third case stemming from that brain-eating amoeba in the last 2 years. The CDC and DHH will continue to monitor the water system and test for that parasitic amoeba in St. Bernard Parish. Back to you.
All right, Rachel, with that report. Since 1962, 128 people in the U.S. have been known to be diagnosed with the disease. Only two have survived. To find out more about the disease and how to protect yourself, we put a link to the CDC on our website, that is WDSU.com.
In the United States, most amoeba infections occur in the South during the summer months. The CDC reports that between 2001 and 2010, 32 infections were reported. Early symptoms of an infection usually show up within 7 days of exposure and include neck stiffness, headache, fever, nausea, and vomiting. Later symptoms include confusion, loss of balance, seizures, and hallucinations can occur. WDSU medical editor Dr. Corey Hebert says people should not be afraid to drink the water.
So the water supply in St. Bernard Parish was never compromised because it's not something that you can drink and then get sick.
So how do people get infected with brain-eating amoeba? Infection starts when contaminated water gets into the nose. The majority of cases are caused by swimming in warm bodies of water. It can also occur from contaminated water sources, such as inadequately chlorinated swimming pool water or heated tap water, less than 116 degrees Fahrenheit. People who use neti pots should only use water that is distilled, sterilized, filtered, or boiled, and then left to cool. Our coverage of the brain-eating amoeba continues online. Go to our website, WDSU.com, for a look at other amoeba cases across the country.
Now,